say they are defending what they call the vulnerable unborn. Rita Chakrabarty has this special report.
Abortion has always attracted protest, but this is something new on British streets. Campaigners from a small group called Abort 67 stand outside the South London clinic, holding up large placards, too graphic to show here, of aborted fetuses at various stages of development. The images are arresting and shocking, and, say the organisers, intentionally so.
We're not here to purposely offend women. Yes, some people may be offended by seeing this.
But these are deliberately offensive, surely. That's what you're saying.
It's disgusting. I don't like looking at these images.
So you are deliberately offending.
But the thing is, we have to ask ourselves the question, why are these so offensive? They're not offensive because of the image. It's offensive because this is happening, because babies are getting slaughtered in the womb. It is totally offensive.
Abort 67 are part-funded by money from the US. Their campaigners wear small cameras which can film anyone in the vicinity. They say they're to protect themselves from false accusations. This form of protest draws some strong reactions from passers-by.
I can understand that they want to protest. But obviously they don't care about people, young children walking past there.
But it's quite bad, to be honest. When you actually do look at it, it's like a proper child. So, it would make me think twice.
I think it's a joke. I think it's a choice. I don't think any woman has an abortion easily anyway. They think you go in there and have an abortion. They don't think it's an hard choice. Especially men.
Blessed are thou amongst women.
Not all groups which campaign against abortion are the same, but although it's been legal for nearly 50 years, bar Northern Ireland, women often have to deal with protesters of all sorts before having this very private act carried out. Over 200 women who've used abortion clinics and been confronted by activists have spoken of their experiences, and their responses have been put together in a study by Aston University, which has been shown to the BBC. It makes interesting reading. One woman said, "It made me scared to come in and I was physically shaking." Another said, "I did feel harassed and violated as I was being filmed against my will." And a third woman said, "The moment I saw them outside, I was panicked and shy. They're intruding on my personal decision, one way or the other." When this woman had an abortion, she was confronted not by graphic images, but by two nuns waiting for her outside the clinic.
I felt embarrassed. Felt very small and very lonely, and it hurt. It feels like a violation of when you're trying to protect yourself and your well-being, and have someone come in and protest and judge you without knowing circumstances, or it was difficult.
Abortion is, for some, highly controversial, and the question remains of how to balance the right to free speech and protest with a woman's right to health privacy. Rita Chakrabarty, BBC News.
James Bond is back on